Welcome to the service clinic at Low Country Harley-Davidson. I'm Doc Harley. Today's subject, fuel gauges. Yeah, I've gotten a lot of emails and messages. How do these things work? And why don't they work a certain direction? And how? A lot of questions about fuel gauges. So let's first start with history. When I started riding motorcycles, we had an odometer, if you were lucky, in the speedometer, and you had a fuel valve. And you'd be riding along, and all of a sudden your bike would start jerking all over the place. You'd reach down and you'd turn this to reserve and you'd go find a gas station. And hopefully you remembered to put this back up, because many of us forgot and you'd run completely out of fuel and there was no reserve if you left it in the wrong position. But anyway, the way you knew your motorcycle was, after a while you knew that 130 miles, 120 miles, hey, it's time to go find a gas station before this thing needs to be turned on it. And that was a kind of a mental note. Well, in 1980, Harley-Davidson decided to offer an accessory for the FLT, and that started the fuel gauge on a Harley-Davidson. Let me start with the fuel flow of a fuel gauge. You turn your ignition on, power comes from the battery through the accessory side of the circuit breakers and goes up to your fuel gauge and powers the little light in the back for the background light. At the same time, 12 volts is going down to the fuel sending unit, which is a variable resistor on a float. And that would send a signal back up to the fuel gauge and tell you how much fuel you had by how much resistance in the variable resistor. Now, in the early days, as this float up and down and you'd go this way and this way and accelerate and brake, well, this little needle would be doing the dance back and forth. So the very first thing Harley-Davidson built in was a dampener in the fuel gauge. And this might explain to you why, after you fill up your gas tank, it takes forever for that fuel needle to go to full. It's because it's dampening the effect of this and getting the readings from your fuel sending unit. Also, it might explain why it goes down so. It's taking the average of this going up and down and where the needle should be. So that's why it takes forever for it to show up on how much you are using up on it. You'll also notice in the 1980s, you see this here, you have a fuel tank facing this direction, and the hump of the frame where the fuel tank would come down would be really, really close. And the opening to put this in was really small, so sometimes this arm got bent and it would be too close. And as this came up, it would ride on the fuel tank. And after a while, it would just kind of hold it there. And sometimes people had full reading on the gauge, but empty tank. So as Harley-Davidson created the newer fuel gauges, they put it on the opposite side. Here's a late 70s, 80s type of fuel. They put the fuel pump, the fuel variable sending unit, and the fuel filter up here. And as you can see, over a period of time, they don't float anymore. And the accuracy of these gets really dicey. Also, the inside of the variable resistor wears, and then the signal isn't as accurate. Let's bump up to the more modern one, still in the same package. We've got the fuel filter, the regulator, the fuel pump, and a variable resistor that is a whole lot more accurate, all right? It is measured by ohms, and the ohms are now 240 at empty and about 40 at full. So, and this floats really nice, and it's away from the inside of the tank. It works real well. I can give you a little tech tip right here. If you wanted to service your fuel regulator, this is inside. After you take your screws out, you have to reach in here, and you have to push down to unlock, and then everything comes up, and when you put it back in, it'll lock back into place. But with the new modern and better float variable resistor, they also added to the speedometer the little yellow light. Or on some of your touring bikes, when you get to almost no fuel, your odometer goes blank and says you are low, and that means you really better find a gas station. So with the little yellow light came back to the early fuel gauges. When you accelerated, decelerated on the very first ones, it would flicker on and off. So Harley-Davidson put in some software. All right, so the little low fuel light should come on between 0.7 and 1.3 gallons. Now the gauge has software filter that limits the lamp reaction when the ignition is turned on. and off. Each time the rider turns the ignition switch on and off, the software filter resets to the current fuel level value. This brings up a story. Received a story where this guy was riding along and listening to the Clemson Carolina game, didn't want to miss a moment of it. A little yellow light popped on. He goes to the gas station, just hits the off for the engine, but leaves the ignition on because he wants to listen to the game. Fills up the tank, pays for it, gets back on, starts the motorcycle and goes down the road. And 10 miles down the road, this little yellow light is still glowing on and it's driving him nuts. How come it's on, Doc? It's because you didn't turn the ignition off so it could get the current reading when you turned it back on, turned the little yellow light on. All right, now the next email that I received about this subject had to do with two guys riding on a trip. Guy on the left, always the yellow light comes on first. They both have the same FLT, they explain. They both ride at the same mile per hour. How come my light always comes on before his? It has to do with conditions. His tires are new. Yours have 5,000 miles on it. He broke his bike on with a little light. You love to rev a little bit. He changes his oil at 3,000 miles. You change yours at 10,000 miles. Condition of the motor and motorcycle have a lot to do with how fast your fuel is flowing. Another condition that you have to be aware of is temperature. We received a bulletin in the V-Rod days that a V-Rod, some variances can be experienced with fuel level sensor reading dependent on temperature of the fuel and the temperature of the fuel tank. Yeah, we used this in racing back in 1998. We would cool the gas tank and cool the fuel so we could get as much fuel in that tank as possible so we didn't have to come in on the pit stop when everybody else did. All right, so the temperature of your fuel tank and the temperature of the fuel going in it has a lot to do with how much that fuel gauge is reading on it. All right, and also the calibration has to do with your speedometer reading each one of them. And that brings up a service bulletin for breakouts. Breakouts built 2012 to 2014 had a better calibration offered. So if you own one and you're feeling like your calibration isn't quite right with the light coming on too soon or something like that, go to your Harley-Davidson dealership and ask them if there's an updated calibration. Also, Sportsters in 2007 had an update in calibration. So it's always good to go to your dealer and say, hey, I'm having this issue. Can you check the variable sender? Can you check my gauges? Can you check the low fuel light? But you also have to know that the low fuel light takes sampling from the fuel tank at 3 to 4 ounces per minute. Now, if you've modified your motorcycle so it drinks a little bit faster, yeah, things are going to change than when you owned your bike stock. I hope explaining how the fuel gauge works and all the variables that go in help you understand and kind of go back to the old days when your little yellow light comes on. Look at your odometer. How many miles did you go? 130, 180, 200 miles? Well, then put a mental note on it that when you get close to that, maybe it's time to go visit the gas station. If you're on a Sportster, maybe in 70 miles, go to find a gas station. The odometer works. Keep in touch with your motorcycle and that will help you know how much fuel and when to fill up. Hope this helped you. A little tech tip from Low Country Harley-Davidson. I'm Doc Harley.